Hi guys, welcome to WebSensePro, welcome to another video. In this video, I'll teach you guys how you can import and export product to your Shopify store. And you might be thinking it's so easy. You have option on your Shopify backend to import and export the products. But in case when you have thousands of products and when you have meta fields and when you have meta fields within variants of those products, then it's a little bit difficult. In this video, I'll cover all of these things and I'll teach you guys how you can import and export products on your Shopify store with all of that extra stuff which you might be needing if you are importing and exporting products. So make sure to watch the complete video, really helpful video for those who are stuck on in the process of import and export of the products. So that's the app which I'll be using. As you can see on my screen, the name is StoreRobo Import Export App. Pretty cool app in which you can export and import all of the data. You can migrate your products, you can export collection, you can export customers and discount. And there are some cool things which I'll show you guys when I'll export the CSV file. So initially I'll show you guys how you can do it via CSV, and in the next part of the video, also show you guys how you can export products via WooCommerce and import that to your Shopify store. So keep watching this video, really helpful video. If you have a WooCommerce store and you are trying to migrate, then this video is also helpful. So initially I'll show you guys how you can do that within Shopify via CSV format. And then I'll show you guys how you can do that in WooCommerce, from WooCommerce to Shopify. So keep watching. So guys, that's the pricing of this app. It just costs you $10 a month if you have 5,000 products, 300 collections, 2,000 customers, and a feature where you can export your WooCommerce product and import via WooCommerce API. So again, I'll also show this part, and initially I'll show you guys how you can export and import via CSV. So that's my store where I will create an export file. So these are the products which I will export from this development store to this development store where I do not have any products on this store. So let's go to the backend of both of the development stores. Now I'm going to open the backend of this development store as well. Okay, so as you can see, I have these 5 products on this development store, and on this one, I do not have any products. So I don't have any products. And within these products, I also have meta fields. So I have this meta field as well, and I'll show you guys, it will export the data of the meta field. And if you do not use this app, the built-in Shopify export function does not have the functionality to export the meta field. That's a drawback when you are using Shopify export import built-in feature. Okay, now I'm going to create an export file using the app. So I already have this app stored on my store, which is StoreRobo Import Export Suite. You can simply go to this link and click on install. I'll add the link in the description below so you guys can easily follow that. Okay, so that's the format which we'll be using. We can also create an export file for Google Shopping Feed, which is Google Merchant Center. So if you are looking to export it for Google Merchant Center for the Google Ads purpose, you can do that as well. By the way, I'm going to create another video for Google Merchant Center because that's a whole another topic, and I have this topic in my mind and I'll definitely create a video for that. Okay, so first let's create an export file with Shopify CSV. Click on proceed, and here it's asking us which object you are looking to export. I'm currently looking to export products. You can export collections, you can export customers and discounts as well. Okay, after selecting the products, let's click on this arrow where it will ask from you that which fields you want to export. So what we want to export is basic columns, obviously, ID, title, vendor, tags, and then we want category, all of the category ID and categories. Similarly, we have this collection option, so I'm going to select that as well. Variants and inventory, whole lot of options which you can choose from. I'm going to select completely and variant custom data. I don't have any variant custom data, so I'm going to skip that. And image data, obviously we will need images of the products. Multi-location inventory, I do not have multi-location inventory, so I don't need that. Meta field, yes, I do have meta field. Again, if you use built-in Shopify functionality, you won't have options like this. So these are the added features which you'll be getting in the Shopify app. And variant meta field, if you have variants in your store, like color or size, and you have meta fields connected to those variants, then you can also export that, which is called variant meta field. I'm going to select that. SEO data, meta title, meta description, that's for that. So I'm going to select that as well. Now I'm going to create an export file by clicking on this export button here. Okay, my export file is going to be ready within a few seconds. Okay, my export file is ready to be downloaded. Now I'm going to click on this download file button. I have this zip folder. Let's extract that. And I have this product export 6.csv file ready. Now I'm going to import that on my other development store. So that's where we will import our products. So I'm going to click on products from a product tab, and let's navigate to the app I have already installed. So let's go to that app. And now here is the section where we will need to upload the file which we downloaded. Now click on this drag and drop, click to upload. And here's our file, product export 6.csv. I'm going to click on open and then click on upload to import the products. Okay. Let's click on import again. Okay, our products has been uploaded, and now click on products, and here we have our products showing up. Now let's click on one of the product to see if the value of the meta fields has been imported or not. So as you can see, the meta field value is also imported. And let's check out the second product just to make sure we have the meta field values imported. Yes, we have the meta field values imported. Okay, now let me show you guys how you can export from WooCommerce and import to your Shopify. So keep watching this video. And this is the website which I'm going to use as an example. And they have about 200 plus products. So they have air conditioners, washing machine, and other products. And we will be, and this website is using WooCommerce, and we will be importing these products into Shopify. So let's start doing that. I'm going to go to the backend of my WordPress website, which has WooCommerce as a plugin to have the e-commerce functionality. I hope you guys have heard about WooCommerce. Most of the audience in my channel is related to Shopify. If you guys have not heard about WooCommerce, it's a plugin which is used in WordPress to enable an e-commerce functionality on your WordPress website. So WordPress is not just for a blog. You can create a complete e-commerce website by using WooCommerce plugin. Okay, so that's the dashboard of my WordPress website. And I'm going to go to WooCommerce and then click on settings. And here I'm going to click on advanced. And then click on REST API. And now we will create a new API key, which we will add in our Shopify app dashboard. So let's go back to our Shopify dashboard. So I'm going to open that in a new tab. And that's the app. As I said, I already have installed that on my development store. And that's the dashboard. So we have multiple options to import our products. We can upload a local file as well. So if you export CSV from your Shopify store or from any other platform, you can import those products via local file as well. You can also input the URL if you have an XML file generated from your store, from your BigCommerce store, from your WooCommerce store, you can simply add in this URL and import those products. So click on WooCommerce API here. And then these are the instructions which I already showed you guys. So you'll be going to WooCommerce settings and create a new API key. And then we will add our consumer key and consumer secret and then domain name here. So let's do that. So here we are from WooCommerce settings, then REST API. And I'm going to click on add key. You can also click on create an API key here. Okay, we will name our API key. Let's name it Shopify. And I'm going to give it read and write permission. And now click on generate API key. And now I'm going to copy and paste the consumer key and the secret key. Don't worry, I'll delete those keys so you guys don't import these products or add products using this API key. So I'm going to delete those. Okay, so let's copy them to our app. That's our consumer key. Let's copy the consumer secret. Now let's add in the domain name. I'm going to copy the URL here and then paste it here and then click on connect. Perfect. You can see that it's now saying that our connection is successful and we are connected with this website here. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to import all of the products. So let's open this products tab. And as you can see, we have these four products on my store and I'm going to be importing all of the 200 plus products from this website. And if I go to the product sections, so click on all products, you can see that we have about 235 products which we'll be importing. Now let's start importing. Let's go back to our app, click on proceed. By the way, we can also import customers and orders as well. So it's not possible to add in orders manually in Shopify. You can import all of your orders if you're migrating from WooCommerce easily through this app. Okay, so you can see that it's connected and it's identified 235 products. We can update those products which are already in the store by selecting this option. We can skip import of new products if we are just replacing the product data. And it's for publish new product that after importing, it will publish it to online store. So I'm going to check mark on this option and then I'm going to click on import. We also have the option to schedule. So if we want to schedule it for the later week or for any other date, we can click on that schedule button and schedule it whenever we want to, right? So for now, I'm going to import it right away. Okay, click on import. And our import is queued. Okay, our import has started. You can see the status as in progress. That's the time of the starting. And it's gonna take a few minutes to import all of the products to Shopify. So ideally, if you have thousands of products on your WooCommerce, you can easily use this app and import all of the products without any manual work. You won't be needing to manually add in the title, product description, images, category, attribute data, variations. So there is a lot of information on the product page, which you might have, which you can easily import using this app. Okay guys, so our import has been completed and you can see that on your dashboard. Now let's take a look on the product section to see how it works. Okay. It took about 3 to 4 minutes to import about 250 products. And you can see it imported all of the images, pricing, stock, and category. Everything has been imported. It also imported the compare price. And that's the compare price tutorial, which I have created recently, which will show you the percentage discount off when you have compare price added on your product. So if you want to learn how to add this section, it's a really cool tutorial which I recently created, link in the description. And let's check out some of the products. Cool. Images are properly imported. Pricings are also imported. Categories. So everything is imported using this app. And it's a perfect app. If you have thousands of products, thousands of variations within those products, then this app is for you. Make sure to check that out. Link in the description. And this is it for the tutorial. Until next video, have a great day.